In this episode, Mike Mee-Bishop is going to explain the savings that you could make by switching to Utility Warehouse. As an example, Mike personally got his home utility bills down from around about £260 a month down to £170 just by switching. And also, there's lots of other interesting side benefits. They'll come and fit your entire house out with LED light bulbs, free, and they'll replace them for life. And those things aren't cheap. If you consider the average house could have 100 bulbs, for example, each one of them is quite pricey, and they're going to come and do it, no hassle, for free, which is immediately going to get your electricity consumption down. So this is like a no-brainer kind of offer. If you want to read more information on this, or if you want to switch your utilities today, you can go to benlowrey.com/utility warehouse. Welcome to the call, Mike. How are you today?
I'm fantastic. Thanks for the invitation, Ben.
Oh, yeah. Well, today we're going to talk about the benefits of Utility Warehouse, because anybody who's listening to this who's responsible for paying the bills in their household could save money by switching to Utility Warehouse. So what's been your experience of it, Mike?
Well, I've known about Utility Warehouse for probably about 12 years, I suppose, something like that, because there's two sides to it. There's a business side, and there's also the savings side. And so people had approached me from the business perspective, and over the years I'd said no, that I wasn't interested. But around about 18 months ago, somebody approached me. At the time, I was looking for other ways of making money, and they sat down and they explained the business side of things. But the thing that attracted it to me as a business is the reason why I'm enthusiastic about it today, is because you've got something that people are currently using, and they can save money on that. Mm. And in the 18 months that I've been involved, I have yet to find a person that I wasn't able to save money.
Is that so? So everybody you've dealt with, you've saved them money on their house bills?
Yeah. I mean, look, people are people. And not everybody I've spoken to, when I've showed them I can make money, some people are skeptical by nature. And so therefore, they would rather stay with who they are than go with somebody that they perhaps not heard of. Mm. But that aside, without exception, there isn't anybody that I've done a full quotation for. There's nobody that I've not been able to save money for.
Now, give us an example. Obviously, I don't want you to mention people's names, but give us an example of somebody, an example of what their bills were before and after they switched.
Okay, there's a friend of ours who, you see, the good thing with this is because it's a discount club, then the more services that you have, the more money you're going to save. So I spoke to a friend of mine, and they looked at I give them a quote on gas, electric, landline, broadband, and SIM. And I saved them £120 a month.
Right.
On what they were currently paying, £120 a month.
That's significant saving, and that's a normal domestic household. That's not like a factory.
Yeah, right? No, well, I mean, that was somebody that they're living in a three-bedroomed terraced house. So I was surprised when I actually, you know, when I was giving them the quote, because normally I would say I would save people around about £250 to £300 a year. That would be the norm.
And what struck me about it is Utility Warehouse does all the switching over for you. You don't have to contact your existing providers and like go through all the hassle and the faff of making all the phone calls. They just do it all, don't they?
Everything is very straightforward. Once you've gone through the quote and you say, right, okay, yeah, we want to, I'm interested, I want to take it further. Basically, that's it. You know, I fill out a few details and it goes off to the company, and then the next thing you know is that everything's switched over for you.
And when did you personally switch your house over to utility warehouse?
Well, that's a very good question, and this is an interesting thing, because when I first looked at it, I thought, I was with some switching thing that would switch my gas and electric over a 12-month, and he would switch it probably about two or three times, and I had to pay £50 a year for that. And so when I got signed up into the business as a distributor, as a promoter, if you like, then I didn't have my gas and electric with them, I'll be honest. And then I thought, well, I can't do this. I can't speak to people about saving money on something that I'm not doing myself. So I went, I did the whole quotation on myself. And even though I was paying £50 a year with this other company and they were switching me two or three times a year, I still saved money on that. And so I changed. I've been with them now, I think it was January 2018.
Right. So you put your mobile phone, your broadband, everything onto Utility Warehouse.
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you get all the electric, the LED light bulbs? Did they come and do that?
Yeah, I mean that's another thing. When you take the whole package with them, then they will change your home over completely with LED bulbs. And my wife was absolutely amazed, because I think it was somewhere in the region about 74 bulbs they put into different carrier bags and stuff like that. And they came to the house, I think they were there probably about an hour and a half, and they changed every bulb in the house.
And they're guaranteed for life, right? So if they break, they'll send you new ones.
Well, that's right. I mean, providing you stay with Utility Warehouse, because, you know, if you go to somewhere else, then obviously they're not going to give you, there has to be something in it for them. But providing you stay with Utility Warehouse, if a bulb goes, they'll replace the bulb free of charge.
Now, people can figure out a quote, right? There's an online tool. Now, I've got it set up on benlowrey.com/join the club. Is that the page? Yeah. Is Join the Club the page where they can put in their details and figure out how much they're going to save? I'm not sure.
Yeah, yes. It's you've got me now, because I haven't got my my page open. But yes, I'm sure that is the link.
Yeah.
You go in there and you can go through, put your details in, and see how much you're going to save. But what I would recommend to people is to see what the saving is with the full the full amount of services. Because there's something that they've just brought on as well, which is boiler cover. Now, I'm going to mention this because it's a really big thing, because if you add this into the mix as well, it gives you even further savings. The boiler cover is £18, right? Now, it doesn't only just cover the boiler, but it covers the central heating system. It covers your electricity, you know, your electrics in the home. It covers a yearly service on the boiler and any breakdown with the boiler. It covers pests, so if you were to get any mice or rats or anything like that in the home, then it would cover dealing with that. And if you lost your keys or a key broke in the lock or something like that, cover that as well. But the other thing that it and that in itself is cheaper than everybody else on the market.
Right.
Because I was paying £10 a month with British Gas just for the pest and key cover. Okay, but if you take that out as well, so if you add that into the mix as well, it's going to give you an additional 10% saving on your gas.
I see. So by taking out that cover, they reward you with an additional 10% saving on the gas. So so let's just say, for example, your gas is £100 a month. I don't know if it is or not.
Yeah,
but
that
you get £10. So by paying £18, you not only get the cover, but you get £10 off your gas.
£10 off the gas, yeah. So it works out that you're paying £8 for the cover, and you couldn't buy the cover anywhere at that price.
Yeah.
So it's I'm really enthusiastic about people looking at the full spectrum of this, so that when they do a quote, that they have all the services to really see how much they can save just on the services. I mean, there are other ways of saving money again, which I'm sure that we're going to talk about now. But I mean, just on that, so if somebody was going onto your link and now they were going to do a quote, I would encourage you to do the full quote. So include the mobile and include the broadband and whatever the landline in on that.
So when you talk about the coverage, so that, like, if your boiler breaks down, that insurance will that pay out for a new boiler? Or is it just repairs?
That's a very good question, and I really don't know the answer to it. From past experience, I have had some cover where it did pay out for a new boiler. If the boiler was under a certain amount of years old, I think it was under 7 years old, it would have paid out for a new boiler. But most boilers, I mean, they last you about 15 to 18 years anyway. Mm. But the other thing that you've got on that is they will repair it. They will repair it, and they will. If the thing is completely broken down, I think you're gonna have to invest in a new boiler. But I like I said, if it's about certain years, from past experience, if it's a certain amount of time old, then they cover it. But what I do know is that they will. You can get a discount if you do have a boiler. You can get a discount on the boiler, on a new boiler by the company that's supplying the policy.
Mm. And okay. Now, there's multiple ways you save money with Utility Warehouse. One of them is the cashback card. So, when you top up this card, and then when you go and do your normal shopping, there's quite a wide range of retailers that they're partnered with, isn't there? And you get 3 to 5% that gets knocked off your utility bill. So if I go to Halfords, is one of them, right?
Yeah.
Or Sainsbury's is one of them, I think.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
There's loads.
There's quite a few. Which you'd be able to see if you're going on the site. There, you'd be able to see all the ones that are available.
Yeah. And so, let's say I spend £100 in Halfords, for example. I don't know what it is, but between 3 and 7% of that will get knocked straight off the utility bill.
Yeah. So let's say, for argument's sake, it was Halfords, and if Halfords is 7%, which I don't have that in front of me now, but if it was 7%, then you'd have £7 back, and the £7 would come off your bill that month.
Do you use the card?
Yes.
All right. Okay.
Yeah. Let me just explain how the card works, because some people think, oh, well, it might be a credit card or something like that. Basically, if you think of the old top-ups, the Sims, where you would top it up as you're using the thing, this card is done in exactly the same way. So what you do is you get the card, you top that card up, and every time you use the card, regardless on who it's with, every time you use the card, you're going to get 1% back. Right, so if they're not partnered with Utility Warehouse, you're still going to get 1% on using the card. But if there are suppliers that they are linked with, then you get between 3 to 7%.
Have you ever signed up a business onto Utility Warehouse?
Not yet.
Okay,
but you can, and they have benefits. It's not working the same way as it is with. Residential, but there are benefits to them, and they can use they can have a cashback card for their business as well.
Right, I see.
And the other thing, as well as the cashback, you can also go online. They have cashback things set up with over 2,000 online retailers. And you can save up to 10% on that. And when I went away recently, we flew with Emirates, and I booked my flight through the site. I think I got about 3% back. And I think it came to somewhere in the region of about £65 that I had off my bill.
Wow. Okay. So that brings your utility bill right down, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, it all helps. It all helps.
Mm, yeah. The only reason I'm not I rent, I lodge in a house, so I'm not in charge of the house utility bills, and the landlord's just about to emigrate to Australia, so that's the only reason I'm not personally a customer of Utility Warehouse. If I had my own place, I would be, for sure.
Well, I'm sure that there's I'm sure that there's something we can explore.
yeah, that's right.
Well, but now the other thing with the cashback, you get so if you get the whole lot like that and you get the cashback card, you also get the Gourmet Society membership card.
Mm.
And people say to me, well, we don't go for meals that much, and you know. Well, I tell you what, it's surprising how many times I've gone and used that card. Mm. I think one restaurant I was in not so long ago, I was working away, and I met a friend of mine, and we went for something to eat, and we went in, I think it was ZZ that we went into, and we had 50% off the whole bill, which included the food and the drink.
Nice.
You know, and so you can get up to 50% off meals, and in some cases, meals and drinks. There's over 6,500 different restaurants you can do that. And on top of that, you can get 40% off cinema tickets.
Is that a top-up card that you got to put money on, or do you just show them the card?
No, just show them the card. You get that almost like as a thank you for taking the cashback card out. And normally that would be £69 a year, but you're saving that. So if you look at it in terms of, let's say that you're going out for a family meal, and let's use ZZ as an example, and you've gone there, and the bill is £100, and so you use your card, and it's £50.
Mm.
Well, you know, you would have spent the £100 normally, but now you only spend £50. You've saved yourself £50. So the savings in all different ways through it, you know.
So when you tell people about this, you're a lifetime salesperson. You've had a lot of experience with sales, and I haven't. I mean, I do stuff mostly online, and I've never done face-to-face selling, really. So how receptive are people to this? Do people generally, they're open to hearing about the savings?
A big sigh. It's funny, right? Because a person that I call a friend, because I've known him for many, many years, I was sat in his living room, and it was like pulling teeth for him, for me to get him to go online. And I could save him, it was £240, and he didn't do it, right? He didn't do it. And the reason that he didn't do it was because he said, well, I haven't really heard of them. And I said, well, okay, so do some research, which he did. And he said, well, he went onto one site, and it showed something like 67% mark. And then I said, okay. I said, well, put N-Power in then and see what their mark is. And their mark was 4%. So he was using N-Power, and they were 4%, and Utility Warehouse was 67% on the site that he went on.
Mm.
And then he went on the Witch thing, and he looked at all the Witch things, you know. But so that's sort of talking to people that you can save people money and they still don't do it. There are people that because my wife's a hairdresser and people come to the house. One person came and I mentioned to her about 2 months ago, and then she said no, and then she came back and I gave her some more information and she said no, and then when she came back a few days ago, she said, we've been having to think about this and we do want to save money, so can you come and see us?
Mm.
So I think the important thing is that just because somebody says no, it doesn't mean no full stop. It means no for now. And you don't know what it is. You don't know the reason why they've said no.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I've had a family member who said, well, look, I want to pay my gas and electric by having a bill come in every quarter. I said, okay, because we're old-fashioned and I don't like to do that through a standing order. I said, great, okay. So I said, how do you do your Sky?
Yeah.
We do that through standing order. I said, well, there you go. But they still wouldn't do it. My job is not to force people. All I can do is just show them what's available. But how do I deal with people generally? I just say, well, look, you know, if I could save you money, would you be interested in taking a look?
Yeah.
And some are, some aren't. You know, some will, some won't. So what?
What's the broadband speeds like in your personal experience? So that's one thing that would concern me. You know, is the mobile coverage and is the broadband speed going to be, you know, good compared to other options?
Well, there's two. It's a very, very good question, because there's two people, and that was a concern of mine when we're dealing with. There was one of my customers who was a Virgin customer, and their speeds are always, from what I know, because I've never experienced Virgin myself, but they tend to be really, really fast. And she changed over to us, last December? And December just gone. And she said she's over the moon with it. She's not had a problem. Mm. And I can tell you how I've experienced. But it doesn't matter, because I'd be biased. But when I got my customer saying that, and I got another customer who likes to game online, and they run the ultra high D wherever it's given out in Sky or BT, they want the best picture they can get. Mm. And so you need to have a really good speed with that. And again, there's been no complaints from them.
Okay.
So, you know, they changed from Sky. The other one changed from Virgin. No problems.
Have you ever encountered anyone that, for whatever reason, can't get a saving with Utility Warehouse, like on gas and electric?
Because, now, it's a good question again, because what I tend to do, I want to save people money. And, you know, because the discounts kick in, the more things that you have, I tend to go there and I say, right, look, okay, what I want to do, I'm going to give you a quote for gas and electric, but I want to add these other things in, because by adding these other things in, they're going to give you a full discount over the whole thing.
Mm.
Okay. And so when I do that and they see the savings, I can't think when I've had to go back to gas and electric after that.
Mm.
So, to answer your question, I don't really know, because I haven't done that. But we guarantee that we're cheaper than the top six,
mm.
And so much so that there's a double the difference price promise. When you become a double gold member, which is when you have the light bulbs and everything like that. They're so confident that they can save money overall compared to the current suppliers, that they'll give you the double the difference back if you don't.
Yeah.
Now, in my experience, because I was involved with a network marketing company years ago, and one of what they used to stand on was 100% money back guarantee to customer satisfaction.
Right.
And when you have something like that, you know that if the customer doesn't like it for whatever reason, and they're going to get their money back. So if a company like this that say, well, look, we guarantee that if you don't make savings, we're going to give you double the difference back, we can't lose.
How come so many people haven't heard of this yet? Because this company, one of the ways they offer better rates is they're not spending a lot of money on expensive marketing campaigns on TV and stuff. And the way they're doing it is promoting it through people like us. And that's one of the ways they keep their costs down, right?
Yeah. But
surprises me, like, according to the literature on this, on Utility Warehouse, there's only 600,000 customers in the country. So,
yeah.
In other words, that's less than 1% of the countries on this.
Yeah, indeed. It is. And well, yes, it's because it's only done through word of mouth advertising.
Mm.
You know, you won't see it advertised anywhere, and so consequently, it's people like us that, in some way, shape, or form, educate the people, speak to people, or make people aware of what's available.
Mm. Now, It is a network marketing business, which so and we get a commission when people sign up, and if people want to promote Utility Warehouse, they can do the same, right? They can they can be, what do you call it, an authorized promoter? I forgot what it's called. Authorized.
Yes, yeah, authorized promoter. Authorized. So I mean, there's two things to this. You know, there's one of them is if you register as that, so that you are a promoter of the. In want of a better term, a salesperson. Well, you're not a salesperson, but you know, so you'd actually be promoting the services.
Mm.
The other thing is that if you've just joined the club, you can still get benefits by recommending people. And you know, they'll give you providing people take out a certain amount of services. You can then you know, they'll then have a reward for doing that, and then they have a reward at Christmas time as well. They have like vouchers at Christmas, or vouchers at you know, when they've recommended the people.
And if people have got their utilities with Utility Warehouse, it only costs £50 to become a promoter as well, and then you can promote it and get commission on people that sign up.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, if like you were, then you're just coming in and you just want to be a promoter and not, for whatever the reason, not take the services, then it's £100 to do that.
Yeah, I paid £100 to become a promoter because I don't have my own house, so I couldn't do that. I couldn't put my utilities on it.
Yeah, exactly. But if you do. So if you do have your own home and you do take out the services, then to become a customer first and then to become a distributor afterwards, that would cost you £50.
Mm. Mm. Yeah.
And the great thing about that, if somebody does become a distributor and you've experienced this firsthand, as have I, there's a training support system, which I have to say is second to none. It's very informative because this is regulated by Ofcom and Ofgem. Then obviously it needs to people can't go around sort of without the correct knowledge and the correct information. So there's the training and everything there, and you've recently experienced that yourself. And like I say, I think it's a fantastic support system.
The cool thing about this is, you're saving people money on something they're going to buy anyway. You're not asking people to spend more money on some expensive facial cream or some vitamin supplement. We're not asking people to spend. You're asking them to save. That's a big difference.
Oh, of course. I mean, you know, I've done the things like the creams, and I've done the things with like vitamins and stuff like that. And you're right. If people have a lot of disposable income, and they don't mind paying £100 a month or whatever it might be for a cream or something, then great. But what we're talking about here is, just as you said, this is something that people use every day, and there is no super fast gas or super fast electricity. Gas is gas, electricity is electricity, and we pay a supplier for that. So why not pay the least we can for it rather than what we currently pay in? And, you know, like I say, in my experience, well, I'll give an example of what mine were. My gas and electric were £210 a month.
Mm.
The landline and broadband were somewhere, I had that with BT, and they were somewhere in the region about £50. So that was £260 a month.
Mm.
So with Utility Warehouse now, I was paying £185, and I say I was because my bill has actually gone down.
Mm.
It's gone down to £175 a month.
Right.
So I've never been with a company when my bill has gone down.
So it's gone from 260 down to 170 something.
175, yeah. Which is great.
No brainer.
Well, it is. So I mean, it, you know, effectively, it's like I'm getting the broadband for free. If you add this into the thing, because I've got my SIM with that as well, right? So I got my broadband for free. I got the SIM for free, and I'm saving money on what I was paying on the gas and electric.
So let me tell people where to go. If you want to switch your utilities over, go to benlowrey.com/utility warehouse. If you're interested in being a promoter and telling other people about it, getting commission when they sign up, go to benlowrey.com/opportunity. And it's just as simple as that, really, isn't it, Mike?
I tell you what, sometimes when people think, oh, it can't be that simple, but it is. And there are people that are changing their lives with the income that they're able to generate from this as a business. And people are able to go on a holiday in a year. If you can save yourself sort of like £1,200-1,300 in a year, then, you know, that's the cost of a holiday for most people. So
I went to the training day that you have to go on when you become a promoter, and the guy sat next to me was a policeman, and he was saying loads of police have quit their job because they're all becoming utility warehouse promoters and making more money than they do as a cop. And he said there's loads of police leave in the force.
Well, I think I would probably put something on that, but not a caveat. I'm trying to think of the word. I can't think of the word anyway. I'm just going to say, I don't say necessarily police are leaving the police force and saying, let's leave the police force and go into utility warehouse. But what I would say that there are people, especially policemen, that are feel disappointed with the job that they're doing and the things that they're being asked to do within that role, and they're looking for alternative things. Mm. And when they come across this, if they really take a look at this, they realise how good this is. And then it's almost like a no-brainer to say, hey, come on, let's get involved because we can generate a good income. And what I would say, from experience, if anybody got involved in this and worked this as a full-time job, they would be earning far, far more than any full-time job would pay them.
Mm. I think this would particularly suit people that are already meeting and interacting with a lot of people, because when you're meeting a lot of people, you've got a lot of opportunity to tell people about this, right?
Yes. Or you can look at it another way. You can say, right, okay, well, I've got a business and what I need to do is I need to meet people. So how would I do that? I suppose it's the way I think of things, you know, because I look at it and I say, right, okay, well, where can I go that I can meet the people that I can speak to? So in a way, it's something that could, you know. I just to tell you a quick anecdote from when I was involved in this company years ago. Not utility warehouse, but a different company years ago. We used to do business plans. We used to go to people's houses and do business plans. And I was there one night doing a plan, and there was a couple there, and they said, yeah, it looks really good, but we can't really do it because we haven't got any transport. We haven't got a car to get around. And so I said, all right, okay, fine. A couple of days later, so they didn't get involved because of that. A couple of days later, doing another business presentation in a different house, and this girl turns up, about 22 years of age. She was absolutely soaked from head to toe, and she came in, sat down at the end of the evening. Then when I'm asking questions, she apologized for her lateness, and she said, I had to cycle you, she said, because I haven't got a car. And she said, what I've just seen is so exciting. She said, I can't wait to get started because I can see a way that I can generate income to buy a car. So it's amazing, you know. You can have two people see the same opportunity, and one person will look at it and say, find the reasons why they can't do it, and another person will use those reasons to do something, you know. And so I think that when you say that it's because people, it would be good if people did know a lot of people. But there's you know. How do I get to meet a lot of people? I just talk to a lot of people, and the same as you. I think if you're a hermit living in a cave, we can teach you how to get a lot of people.
Right.
So there's a system to help.
Right. Anyone can do it, in other words.
Mm, mm.
Hey, what else you been up to, Mike? How's the weight loss going? You're on a mission.
Yeah, man with a mission. Yeah, I'd say it's going very well. I've recently, when did I go? I was there on Tuesday when we did another weigh-in. I've lost 5 pounds, I think, over the last 3 weeks. Inch and a half off my waist, 2 inches off my hips. And you know what they say, the hips don't lie. So,
how much are you down overall?
It's just over 2 stone, I think.
Wow. You must feel, I saw your video the other day. It was really cool. You said you felt 20 years younger.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, look, I can't sort of like go back in time to say, oh, yeah, this is how I felt. But I know how I felt before Christmas. I know how I felt before doing this. And, you know, and I know how much more energy, more alive I feel, you know. And I know that it takes a while, because it takes a while for you to start to change how you look. But yeah, but that's going to come from the inside. And yeah, I really do. Yeah, I really do. And you see, why I started this at the back in December. One of the things was because I felt that whatever else that I did this year, the foundation for that had to be me being fit and healthy. Mm. You know, that was a prerequisite to have a success in other areas. And they say success breeds success. And of course, if I'm seeing my body shape changing and weight coming off and I'm feeling younger and stuff like that, it has to then have a positive effect on other things that I'm doing. I have to be, you know, I have more energy for things. I have a different outlook on things. You know, I'm a positive guy anyway, but it sort of, the downtimes aren't, you're not down so much, you know, and it's, yeah, it's great. I feel feeling fantastic.
So how much further do you think you can go? What's your target with the weight loss?
Well, I mean, you know, it's very interesting, because at the start, when I started, I felt that I had to have something to aim at, and it was to get down to 14 and a half stone, and I was over 20. Now the thing is, because of my shape, people, whenever they've guessed my weight, are generally about 2 to 3 stone out, and it's under rather than over.
Right.
So, like, you know, I said to somebody, you're 20 stone, and he said, oh, you're about 16. Mm. You know, they thought it was about 16. So, in a way, it's a good thing, but it's not a good thing when you can't bend down, and or when you're bending down to do your shoelaces up, you can't breathe, you know, because there's so much fat there that it's put in a string, you just can't get down to you know, and you, but now it's not a problem. So, I thought, like, let's take a look at 14 and a half stone. Mm. Since that's still a goal, you know, that's still what I'm aiming at. But within that as well is my waist. So I really want to get to a 36-inch waist. So at the moment I'm 43, but I've lost 6 inches off my waist since I've started.
Right.
And that's, I mean, I wasn't wearing jeans, and now I'm back wearing jeans.
Right.
Because I thought I looked stupid wearing jeans, but now I'm wearing them, and I'm thinking, I feel good.
And
I feel good enough.
And how are you doing it, basically? Is it a combination of exercise and diet control?
Yes, it is, yeah. Why I paused then is because I don't have the eating thing, because I tend to be out on the road 2 or 3 times a week, sometimes 5 times a week, but certainly 2 or 3 times a week. Sometimes I don't take the time to prepare stuff to take it out with me before I go. If I'm up early, I use that time to either go to the gym or go out for a walk for an hour, do about 4 or 5 kilometer walk. And so I don't prepare the food. And so that's something now that, because I've got the exercise part of it down, then I need to do that. But what I did, I mean, I got different incentives. I put different things into place to help me along. And I think it's really important if somebody's doing something like this, or doing anything really, that you have sort of cheerleaders, you have people that are supporting you, and people that you can go to for guidance. And, you know, even with you, where we've been to the gym and you said, look, do things in a certain way and you'll get these results. So one of the things that I did is I've got an insurance policy with a company called Vitality. Vitality Health. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that they were offering on there was an Apple Watch. And it said, we'll buy the Apple Watch for you, providing you do so many, you rack up so many points in a week and in a month. Mm. And so it's as long as you get 40 points in a week, then and you do that over a month, then they'll pay what the monthly payment would be for the watch.
Right.
So I'm into, I think it's going into my third one where this has kicked in. And today now I have to do 12,500 steps. Mm. I've already done 6,500. So I've got another 6,000 to do. And I will, and that would be me done for the month, and the watch is paid for again. Oh. So that's an incentive that I'm thinking, no, if somebody's going to do that, if I'm going to get a watch for almost nothing, then I'm going to put the effort in to do that. And so what I do is I go to the gym and I work out. I watch YouTube quite a bit for things that will help me shorten the time. So there's what I've seen is they'll show you workouts there. They say, right, you do these five exercises and it's going to give you these results, you know. So I'm looking at things that I can do at home if I can't make it to the gym. And I've also got myself a rebounder, which mm-hmm. is one of those little trampoline things.
Yeah.
And the research that I've done into that is that the great thing about it is that if you've got any joint pains or stuff like that, so if you were a runner, then you're able to exercise on the rebounder and it won't put the joints under stress. Mm. And it's one of the only things that you can use that will move the lymph around the body.
Right.
Which is, again, it's getting rid of the waste, and so that's quite important. So I use that as well. So if I haven't done my 12,500 steps, which invariably I don't get to do throughout my working day, if you like, so I might be in, say, about 6 o'clock, something like that, then between 6 and the time that I go to bed, I make sure that I finish off on the rebounder. Sometimes it may be 40 minutes, but, if that's what it takes, then that's what I do.
Brilliant, and that all contributes towards the steps and the points and the free watch.
Yeah, yes, yeah, definitely. And and if anybody else would like a free watch, then let me know, and I can recommend them to somebody that can give them a quote. But so that's a good thing. And when I was in Australia earlier in the year, I have my niece and her husband, and her husband is a an Ironman. He's he's very, very fit. Mm. She's done triathlons as well.
Wow.
And so I get a lot of support from them. I almost video them every day and send them a video, tell them what I've done, and the feedback that I get from them and the encouragement and stuff, that's really great. So I think it's important that if you're going to do something like that, that you have cheerleaders and you have people saying, yeah, well done, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
You can do it, like, you know.
Fantastic.
So I think that if I don't hit 14,500 by the end of the year, will I be disappointed? Well, I tell you what, I feel absolutely fantastic to where I've got to now. Mm. And I realize that no matter what goal you've got, it takes effort. You have to put the effort in. But it's got to a point now where I don't feel it as an effort. I'm enjoying what I'm doing. And but the one thing I will say, it's important to get the right equipment, because I had a pair of walking shoes, like mountain walking and stuff like that. And I just wore normal socks. And the calluses that were coming up on my feet and the blisters and stuff, it was terrible. So part of the vitality thing is that they want you to get fit and healthy, and so they get 50% off a pair of running shoes with runner's need.
Right.
So I went across to them and I explained to them, and they said, well, these are the shoes we recommend. And you need these socks as well.
Yeah.
And I'd never thought of the socks. And since I put the socks on, I've had no problems at all with blisters or anything uncomfortable when I'm walking. So it's So it's really important that even if you're going to just start walking, make sure you've got the right equipment. You know, make sure you've got a decent pair of shoes for fit for purpose, and you've also got walking or running socks, because you know they'll save you hours of discomfort.
All right, good stuff. So, so Mike, if people want to contact you about that, well, what's the best thing? Do you want to give out your email address?
Yeah. Well, if you get in touch with me on MMB Promotions, hang on a second. I give it out, but I forget. If you can just bear it. Hang on. Right, MMB Promotions mail. That's all one word. @gmail.com.
Okay. Okay. All right. Good stuff, Mike. So, just for the people listening, once again, if they go to benlowrey.com/utilitywarehouse, they can look through all the information and they can do their comparison quotes and figure out how much they can save. All the information's there. Anything else to add, Mike?
No, well, I mean, you know, if there is anybody that's from that, is interested in looking at this as a way that they can save money and make money, obviously you've got your link there. You can give him your link. But because we're working closely together, you know, I'd be working with them to help them put things together as well. So,
they've got support here if they need it.
Without a shadow of a doubt, yeah. So, that's great.
Fantastic. Good stuff, Mike.
Excellent.
We'll catch up again soon then.
Yeah, well, thanks for the opportunity to have a chat about it.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you. We'll talk about different topics next time.
Okay.
We can talk about the ghosts and stuff.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
Bye for now, Mike.
Bye. All right. Cheers, Ben. Bye.